Hello friends, in this video we are going to know about Congo fever. We will see how this fever is caused, what are the symptoms of this disease, how this disease is transmitted, how can we prevent this disease from spreading, and what is ribavirin and does it help in treating Congo fever. So let's begin. Crimean Congo hemorrhagic fever, CCHF, is caused by infection with a tick-borne virus, nidovirus, in the family Bunyaviridae. This disease was first characterized in Crimea in 1944 and given the name Crimean hemorrhagic fever. Symptoms of this virus may include fever, muscle pains, headache, vomiting, diarrhea, and bleeding into the skin. And complications may include liver failure. Now we'll see how this virus is transmitted. Numerous wild and domestic animals such as cattle, goats, sheep, and hares serve as amplifying hosts for the virus. Transmission to humans occurs through contact with infected ticks or animal blood. CCHF can be transmitted from one infected human to another by contact with infectious blood or body fluids. Now we will see that how can we prevent this disease from spreading. Where mammalian tick infection is common, agricultural regulations require de-ticking farm animals before transportation or delivery for slaughter. Personal tick avoidance measures are recommended, such as use of insect repellents, adequate clothing, and body inspection for adherent ticks. When feverish patients with evidence of bleeding require resuscitation or intensive care, body substance isolation precautions should be taken. 30% of people who get this disease die, so better take precautions. Ribavirin is an antiviral drug that some doctors use to treat CCHF. It is widely available and it is normally taken by mouth. There is debate over whether ribavirin is needed to treat CCHF. Some argue that it is an effective treatment or helps if given early, while others say that it has no effect in terms of risk of death, the length of time needed in hospital, and the extent of harm from the drug itself. 5 studies were found that took into account important factors that could confound the risk of dying with whether or not a patient received ribavirin. It was found that there is insufficient reliable evidence to determine whether ribavirin is effective or not. So that's it for today's video. Please like and share this video. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please hit that subscribe button and also press the bell icon. Once again, thank you for watching this video.